大家好，
我是 Stella，
我是我的，今天要为您念的是练习手册第21课。我决心以不同的眼光看事情。Lesson 21 I am determined to see things differently。 让我们先来唱吧。
我决心以不同的眼光去看事情。 I am determined to see things differently。
今天的观察显然是继续昨天的观念且加以延伸。The idea for today is obviously a continuation and extension of the preceding one. 然而这次除了随机运用这观念以外，仍需踏实地做审查信念的练习。This time, however, specific mind searching periods are necessary in addition to applying the idea to particular situations as they may arise. 最好练习五次，每次长达一分之久。 5 practice periods are urged, allowing a full minute for each. 开始练习时，先向自己复诵一遍这个观念。 In the practice periods, begin by repeating the idea to yourself.然后闭起眼睛，仔细在心中搜出过去、现在或未来常会激怒你的事件。Then close your eyes and search your mind carefully for situations, past, present, or anticipated that arouse anger in you. 那愤怒的反应可能只是轻微不悦，也可能达到震怒的程度。The anger may take the form of any reaction, ranging from mild irritation to rage. 你感受到情绪强弱并不重要。The degree of the emotion you experience does not matter. 你会越来越清楚，一丝不悦只不过是掩饰震怒的一道屏障罢了。You will become increasingly aware that a slight twinge of annoyance is nothing but a veil drawn over intense fury. 因此，学习时试着不让小小的愤怒之念逃过你的注意。Try, therefore, not to let the little thoughts of anger escape you in the practice periods.请记住，你还无法认清究竟是什么激起你的怒火，而你认定与此相关的原因其实毫无道理。Remember that you do not really recognize what arouses anger in you, and nothing that you believe in this connection means anything.你很可能紧盯着某些情景或人物不放，只因你误以为他们嫌疑比较显著而已。You will probably be tempted to dwell more on some situations or persons than on others, on the fallacious grounds that they are more obvious. 事实并非如此。This is not so.这充其量只能反映出你相信某种形式的攻击比较合理罢了。It is merely an example of the belief that some forms of attack are more justified than others. 你一旦察觉到任何攻击之念浮现时，把它们一个一个放在心中，一会儿同时告诉自己。As you search your mind for all the forms in which attack thoughts present themselves, hold each one in mind while you tell yourself.
我决心以不同的眼光
去看人名。
I am determined to see
name of a person differently.
我决心以不同的眼光
去看，具体的指出某种情境。
I am determined to see.
Specify the situation
differently.
尽可能具体一点。Try to be as specific as possible. 例如，你的愤怒很可能是针对某人的某种性格。你还相信自己的愤怒纯粹是针对这一点而发的？ You may, for example,Focus your anger on a particular attribute of a particular person, believing that the anger is limited to this aspect. 如果你所知所见忍受这类偏见所苦，不妨这样说。If your perception is suffering from this form of distortion, say,
我决心以不同的眼光
去看。人民的某种性格。
I am determined to see.
Specify the attribute in none of person differently. 以下是这种的释义 You are blessed beings indeed. 你确实是有福之人 I am that one that you know as Jesus. And this is one of the fundamental principles that you need to realize that you are pursuing in this practice. 我是你所知的 JC, 本课的练习是基本原则之一。你需要了解你在这课的练习中所要寻求的是 You are determined to see things differently, and that by assumption,means that some of the things you are seeing now and interpreting are incorrect, and you are acknowledging that by your willingness to practice. 你决心以不同的眼光去看事情，这个假定意味着你对目前所看到的一些事情之诠释是错误的。而你透过愿意做这课的练习而承认这一点。It is important for you to remember that you are going to change some things in your world by doing this practice. The practice is a mind transformation process, and therefore, the world that is projected from your mind is going to shift.And change. 重要的是，你需记得，透过这课的练习，你将改变自己世界中的某些事情。这个练习是心灵转化的过程，因此，由你的心灵所投射的世界也会随之转化和改变。This begins to bring up fear in the ego mind because the ego's security and safety is in believing that things should not change, specifically you. 这会开始引发小我之心的恐惧，因为小我的安全和保障有赖于相信事情不应该变，尤其是你。As you know, the ego is an aspect of your mind that has developedusing separation and fear as its foundation. 如你所知，小我是你心灵的一个面向，它是以分裂和恐惧为基础来发展。And so now, as we are going towards love, as you are saying, I need to change the way I see these things that I'm surrounded by, the ego will begin to argue with you and say,Well, hang on a second. We've set up all of these defenses. We've set up all these ways of doing things to keep you safe and away from potential danger, i.e. other beings. Because that is one of the things that the ego wants to do. 因此，当我们正朝着爱迈进时，当你说我需要改变自己看待周遭事物的眼光之时，小我会开始跟你争辩，他会说等等，我们已经设好这所有的防卫措施，我们已经建好这所有的处事方式，以保障你的安全，避免潜在的危机，也就是他人 因为这是小我想要做的一件事。It wants to keep you away from other beings because it perceives that they are going to injure you or hurt you, and that your control of your environment through defensiveness and attack is what is actually keeping you safe. But the truth is, it is actually what's making you miserable or sick.
他想要使你远离他人，他认为他人会伤害你，所以你用防卫和攻击的方式来掌控你的环境，才能真正保障你的安全。但实际上，这样做恰恰使你痛苦不堪或是生病。
And so it is important for you to know that as you go through these lessons, that voice of argumentativeness is going to present itself on a regular basis and made by quite loud at times. But you must go back to the reasons that you begin this course.
因此你务必要知道，在你练习这些课程的过程中，那些争辩的声音会经常出现，有时可能音量很大，但你必须回想你最初学习这部课程的理由。
You must go back to the reasons that you felt that you needed to have your mind changed. It is important that you revisit your initial decision to start the lessons of A Course in Miracles so that you do not forget and listen to the voice of the ego that says, Hey, we were doing great without all of this discipline that beginAsked of us.
你必须回想你认为自己需要改变心灵的理由。你必须回顾你最初开始做奇迹课程的练习之初衷。这样你才不会忘记这个初衷而听从小我的声音。他说，嘿，若没有这项锻炼的种种要求，我们会活得很好。
Let's go back to doing what we have always known and what we have always done.
小我说，让我们恢复我们一向知道且一直在做的事。
But as you know, if you always do what you have always done, you will always get what you have always gotten. And if that is not what you want and how you wish to express yourself and live, then you must be determined to continue on these lessons regardless of the commentary that's coming from the separated part of your mind, which you call the ego mind.
然而如你所知，如果你一直做着你一向在做的事，你永远会得到你一向获得的结果。如果这个结果不是你要的，不是你想要展现自己及生活的方式，那么你必须下定决心继续做这些练习。不管你心中分裂的哪一部分所发出的评论如何，那一部分的心灵就是所谓的小我之心。
And so we are very proud of you for coming this far, and we challenge you today to begin to share these videos, whether or not you feel that anyone else in your group or your gathering place, your Facebook page, for example, is going to understand them.
我们为你能练习到这一刻为荣。我们今天给你一项挑战，请你开始分享这些录像，不论你认为自己的团体或社群，例如脸书的其他人是否会了解这些内容。
It is a great gift to humanity for you to share this series of lessons for those beings who may be suffering and may not know of its exist. It isA wonderful, wonderful thing for you to contemplate doing.
你分享这一系列的课程乃是赠予人类的一份大礼。那些正在受苦的人可能并不知道这部课程的存在，所以你考虑做这个分享可说是非常非常美好的一件事。
And if you are too frightened to do it because you fear persecution or judgment from others, then you can look at the little secret that is hiding in your mind, that you care more about what others think than for the health
and well-being of your fellow brothers and sisters.
如果你太害怕而不敢分享，因为你害怕遭到迫害或是其他人的批评，那么你可以看看你心中隐藏的那个小小秘密，你在乎别人的看法，更甚于你在乎你的同伴、弟兄姐妹的健康与福祉。
That is a good thing to know that is lurking in your mind, and you can work on that as well as we go through these lessons.
能够在你的内心看到这一点是非常好的一件事，使你能够在观念上下功夫，同时跟着我们继续做这些练习。
I am that one that you know as Jesus, and we are very pleased that you are here, and we will see you again tomorrow.
我是你所知的 JC, 我们非常高兴你在这里，我们明天再会。
可恩要我们参考教师指南第十七章第四节第五句话。引言的最后一句，可恩已经在第十六课提过了，这是奇迹课程最常被人引用的名句。
This last line is the one Kenneth mentioned earlier in lesson 16, one of the more famous lines in A Course in Miracles.
这个观念如此重要，耶稣在教师指南再次逐字重述了一遍。
It is so important, in fact,that Jesus virtually repeats it in a manual of teachers.
教师指南第十七章第四段，没有人会对一个单纯的事实而发怒的，只要记住这一点，对你的帮助一定很大。
Perhaps it will be helpful to remember that no one can be angryAt a fact.
任何负面的情绪都是你的诠释勾引出来的，不论你是为了某种装饰事实的现象而气得理直气壮。
It is always an interpretation that gives rise to negative emotions, regardless of their seemingjustification by what appears as facts.
也不论你的怒气多强或多弱，
regardless too of the intensity of the anger that is aroused.
即使只是轻微的不悦，轻微的令人难以察觉，
it may be merely slightirritation, perhaps too mild to be even clearly recognized.
即使你已怒火中烧，生出了暴力的念头，不论你只是在脑海里遐想或具体付诸行动。
Or it may also take the form of intense rage, accompanied by thoughts of violenceFantasized or apparently acted out.
这一切都无关紧要。
It does not matter.
所有的情绪反应却是同一回事。
All of these reactions are the same.
他们只是企图蒙蔽真相而已。这与你的情绪的强弱无关。
Obscure the truth, and this can never be a matter of degree.
真相对你若非历历在目，就是隐晦不明。
Either the truth is apparent, or it is not.
你不可能只认出部分的真相。
It cannot be partially recognized.
你若看不到真相，表示你已落入幻想了。
Who is unaware of truth must look upon illusions.
正文第六章 导言第一段第二句话。愤怒通常都是分裂心态投射出去的结果，因此当事人终究得为自己的愤怒负责，无法怪罪他人。 Anger always involves projection of separation, which must ultimately be accepted as one's own responsibility rather than being blamed on others.
让我们再来唱一次吧。
我决心以不同的眼光去看事情。 I am determined to see things differently. 我决心以不同的眼光去看事情。 I am determined to see things differently.
练习手册第21课。我决心以不同的眼光看事情。 Lesson 21. I am determined to see things differently.
教师指南 Manual for Teachers. 13牺牲究竟是什么意思？ 13. What is the real meaning of sacrifice?
牺牲这一名词在真理内虽然毫无意义，在人间却充满了意义。 Although in truth the term sacrifice is altogether meaningless, it does have meaning in the world. 它的意义就像世上所有事物一样，只有一时的效用。当它的功用用尽，其意义终将隐没于它所源自的虚无中。 Like all things in the world, its meaning is temporary and will ultimately fade into the nothingness from which it came when there is no more use for it. 然而在此，它真正的意义则成了我们的必修课程。Now its real meaning is a lesson. 它就像所有的课程一样，人在幻想之列，因为在实相内没有什么好学的。Like all lessons, it is an illusion, for in reality there is nothing to learn. 但我们仍需一个修正方案来取代这个幻想，也就是以另一个幻想来取代前一个幻想，最后两者方能一并消失。 Yet, this illusion must be replaced by a corrective device, another illusion that replaces the first so both can finally disappear. 前一个幻想必须替换下来新的思想体系，才有立足之地。这幻想即是放弃世间任何东西，都是一种牺牲。 The first illusion which must be displaced before another thought system can take hold is that it is a sacrifice to give up the things of this world.还有什么比这更虚幻的看法？整个世界本身就是一个大幻象。 What could this be but an illusion, since this world itself is nothing more than that? 需要相当的羞耻才可能明白并接受世界不能给人任何东西这一事实。 It takes great learning both to realize and to accept the factthat the world has nothing to give. 牺牲虚无的说法究竟有何意义？ What can the sacrifice of nothing mean? 它不可能意味你会因此而拥有更少。 It cannot mean that you have less because of it. 在世俗的认知下，没有一种牺牲不涉及你的身体层次。There is no sacrifice in the world's terms that does not involve the body. 你不妨反思一下，人间所谓的牺牲指的究竟是什么？ think a while about what the world calls sacrifice. 权力、名位、金钱、生理的娱乐，哪样不属于所谓的梦中英雄？ Power, fame, money, physical pleasure. Who is the hero to whom all these things belong? 他们除了对身体有价值以外，还有什么意义？ Could they mean anything except to a body? 然而，身体本身没有评估价值的能力。Yet a body cannot evaluate. 是心灵为了得到这些东西，不惜与身体沆瀣一气，存心蒙蔽自己的真实身份，而模糊了他的真相。By seeking after such things, the mind associates itself with the body, acquiring its identity and losing sight of what it really is. 人心一旦产生这种混淆，就再也无法认清世上所有的娱乐都虚幻得很这一事实了。Once this confusion has occurred, it becomes impossible for the mind to understand that all the pleasures of the world are nothing. 这究竟会带给人多大的牺牲？那牺牲可大了。But what a sacrifice, and it is sacrifice indeed.All this entails. 从此，心灵开始诅咒自己求而不得，永远无法活得心满意足，最后连自己真正想要找什么都搞不清了。Now has the mind condemned itself to seek without finding, to be forever dissatisfied and discontented, to know not what it really wants to find.谁能躲避得了这种自我诅咒？ Who can escape its self-condemnation? 唯有上主的圣言才有此可能。Only through God's word could this be possible. 自我诅咒乃是对自己身份的一种选择或决定，没有一个人会怀疑心目中所认定的自己。For selfCondemnation is a decision about identity, and no one doubts what he believes he is. 他可能怀疑其他的一切，但绝不会怀疑这个自己的。He can doubt all things, but never this. 上主的教师已经能够毫无遗憾地舍弃人间的娱乐了。God's teachers can have no regret.On giving up the pleasures of the world. 舍弃痛苦岂能算是一种牺牲? Is it a sacrifice to give up pain? 成人岂会因为放弃痛患而恼怒不已? Does an adult resent the giving up of children's toys? 已能看清基督圣容的人岂会留恋人间这座屠宰场?Does one whose vision has already glimpsed the face of Christ look back with longing on a slaughterhouse? 已由生老病死的世界解脱出来的人也不会回头去诅咒世界的。No one who has escaped the world and all its ills looks back on it with condemnation.但他必会庆幸自己摆脱了世俗价值向他所求的一切牺牲。Yet he must rejoice that he is free of all the sacrifice its values would demand of him. 只好上穷碧落下黄泉的追寻，每当自以为找到了时，结果都是令人失望的一场。And so he seeks it in a thousand ways and in a thousand places, each time believing it is there and each time disappointed in the end. 去找但不要找到，那是世界最无情的游戏规则了。凡是追求世俗目标的人都过不了这一关的。 Seek.But do not find, remains this world's stern decree, and No one who pursues the world's goals can do otherwise.
你也许认为本课程会要求你牺牲自己的所爱。
You may believe this course requires sacrifice of all you really hold dear.
从某种角度来讲，可说是真的，因为你真爱之物正把上主之子钉在十字架上，动弹不得。而本课程的目的是要释放他，还他自由。
In one sense, this is true, for you hold dear the things that crucify God's Son, and it is the course's aim to set him free.
但不要因此而误解了牺牲的意义。
But do not be mistaken about what sacrifice means.
牺牲要你放弃的不外乎你想要之物。
It always means the giving up of what you want.
上主之师啊，你究竟想要什么呢？
And what, O teacher of God, is it that you want?
上主一直召唤着你，你其实已经答复了。
You have been called by God, and you have answered.
如今你难道愿意牺牲这个召唤吗？
Would you now sacrifice that call?
到目前为止，听到这召唤的人少之又少，人们只能转而向你求助。
Few have heard it as yet, and they can but turn to you.
在整个世界中，你成了他们的唯一指望。
There is no other hope in all the world that they can trust.
你的声音成了上主天音的人间的唯一回响。
There is no other voice in all the world that echoes God's.
你若牺牲了这一真相，他们便会一起堕入地狱。
If you would sacrifice the truth, they stay in hell.
他们一旦陷落，你也会与他们一起沉沦的。
And if they stay, you will remain with them.
不要忘了，牺牲是全面的。
Do not forget that sacrifice is total.
没有半得半失的牺牲。
There are no half sacrifices.
你不可能只放弃天堂的一部分。
You cannot give up heaven partially.
你也不可能只坠落地狱一点点。
You cannot be a little bit in hell.
上主圣言的作用也是全面的。没有例外。
The word of God has no exceptions.
正是这一特质造就了他的神圣性，且超越三界之上。
It is this that makes it holy and beyond the world.
这一神圣性直至上主之境。
It is its holiness that points to God.
这一神圣性保障了你的安全。
It is its holiness that makes you safe.
只要你一攻击弟兄，不论任何原因，救赎便会离你而去。
It is denied if you attack any brother for anything.
因为这等于重蹈了天人分裂的覆辙。
For it is here the split with God occurs.
分裂原是不可能存在的。
A split that is impossible.
也不可能发生
，a split that cannot happen。
但你对他笃信不疑，因为你已经现身于一个不可能存在之境了。
Yet a split in which you surely will believe because you have set up a situation that is impossible。
在这处境下，所有不可能的事好似都可能发生。
And in this situation, the impossible can seem to happen.
它一旦发生了，你就不能不付出牺牲真相的代价了。
It seems to happen at the sacrifice of truth.
上主之师，切莫忘了牺牲的意义，并且记住你所做的每一个决定不会不牵涉某种代价的。
Teacher of God, do not forget the meaning of sacrifice and remember what each decision you make must mean in terms of cost. 你若选择上主，这一切对你都成了平白的恩赐。Decide for God, and anything is given you at no cost at all. 你若决定背弃上主，就等于选择虚无，那么你就会丧失所有的觉知力。Decide against him, and you choose nothing at the expense of the awareness of everything. 你究竟想要传授别人哪一种选择？ What would you teach?你只需记住自己究竟想要学到什么就够了。Remember only what you would learn. 这才是你该用心之处。For it is here that your concern should be. 救赎是为你而设的。Atonement is for you. 你透过学习而领受救赎，也透过学习而给出救赎。Your learning claims it, and your learning gives it. 世界容纳不下它。The world contains it not. 但你只要学习本课程，救赎便非你莫属。But learn this course, and it is yours. 上主把他的圣言交托给你，因为他需要上主之时。God holds out his word to you, for he has need of teachers.除此之外，还有什么更好的拯救上主之子的方式？ What other way is there to save his son?
教师指南 Manual for Teachers 13牺牲究竟是什么意思？ 13. What is the real meaning of sacrifice? 祝大家有个闪闪发光充满爱的一天。 Amen. 我爱你。